Hi, everyone. Welcome to HVTV. I'm your host, Jeremy Breisel. JB, glad to be with you once again for a tremendous conversation with the CEO of Hitachi Vantara, Gajen Kandiah. Gajen, thanks for being with us.
Thank you, JB. It's great to be here.
Your story is fascinating. So on the business side, you founded an internet startup, had tremendous success there. Then you led Cognizant through a period of just absolute hyper growth. And now you're at Hitachi Vantara as CEO in a unique era, let's say the least. What I'm curious about, though, not just from the business side, but also from the personal side, is what has been the biggest influences on you in your leadership style?
Two of the most important and most pivotal influences in my life, if you will, were one, my parents, right? I grew up an army brat. My dad was in the army. And I learned a ton by just watching, right? Watching him and being with him and traveling with him. And so I learned a lot about discipline and execution from him. And then my mom, who was a Montessori teacher and taught kindergartners. And so, you know, she taught me sort of this sense of empathy and the sense of, you know, like how to deftly navigate, you know, both good and not so easy situations. So that was one big part of it, right? And the second part is how I ended up in the U.S. You know, I grew up in Sri Lanka. We left in the midst of a civil war, right? And we didn't really have a choice. And so, you know, I was transplanted from a place where I had a reasonably happy, fun life, you know, enjoying learning, playing sports, and so on and so forth. Suddenly in the middle of Boston, in Somerville, Massachusetts, with really sort of no real clear view of what I was doing or where I was going to go. And so I had to build everything from scratch. And I went through a whole journey of doing that. I had to pretty much fight for everything, right? You had to sort of work hard for every single thing you got. And then you got into the rooms you wanted to get into, and then you looked around and sort of you weren't being heard. You needed to find your voice. You needed to find sort of who am I and why is what I'm about to say going to be important? And as I was listening, I realized that I had this ability to synthesize stuff, right? And be able to put things together in a way that made sense. And then I would speak up. And now I had a voice, if you will, right? And so what I learned from that is there are going to be a lot of those people in the rooms that you're in. Now you're sitting at the table, you know, maybe leading those conversations, managing and facilitating. So remember, everybody has a voice. Everybody has a point of view. Give them the opportunity to voice it, right? Have open debates. Let people feel like they can be open with you and create an environment in which they can be open, and then pull it together, right? Tie it together, synthesize it, and then lead businesses. And I think those lessons, if you will, or those sort of moments of time that as I go back and think about it, have been critical in terms of my professional career and sort of the opportunity and the privilege that I have today to come and lead Hitachi Vantara.
Well, it is certainly a remarkable story. Your parents, clearly remarkable people. You took over at Hitachi Vantara at what we hope is a once-in-a-lifetime event. And it's been a unique experience to not be able to have a town hall in person, to not be able to walk the halls of an office, to meet 10,000 people virtually. How have you taken on that challenge?
The good news is I'm not the only one dealing with that challenge, irrespective of whether it's a new role or you know, somebody that's already been in a role. But just starting in a role like this, you know, I haven't really met anybody from my team so far, right? And that has been quite an interesting journey, right? I think one of the first things I would say I have learned is that you just need to take the time to do a lot more engagement, right? So meeting as many people as possible, both across and deep within the organization, to get to know them, even if it means 3 to 4 meetings to get to know somebody, has been one sort of mechanism, if you will. The other one is, you know, how do you, you know, and understand and sort of ask the right questions, right? Like, you know, like, because the questions are different because you're trying to figure out what works in this environment, what works for our clients, what works for our people. And so trying to really hone in on the right questions to ask and how to ask those questions while staying open and listening a ton, right? One of the things Dad's always said to me is, you know, remember this, right? You have 2 ears and 1 mouth, so make sure you use them proportionally. And that's always in the back of my mind because ultimately, you know, you got to change the culture, change the product line, you know, lead the company through a very tough time. and do all of that in this virtual model. And so it's been you know, mostly interesting and exciting. It's got its challenges, but you know, but I think we're all navigating through that together.
That's such a great point about the communal aspect of this challenge, and that within the challenge there is opportunity. You mentioned clients. Obviously, leading the organization is one aspect of it, but the business revolves around clients. You have to be client-centric in this environment, in this virtual space. How do you do that?
So, great question, right? In fact, that was one of the things that was in the back of my mind coming into this role. However, what's been really, really fantastic is as we move to this virtual model, our clients have so much more time, but also our clients are so much more willing to engage. So they have more time for us as partners to be able to engage and have conversations about what their needs are, how we can work with them, how we can co-create with them. It's a really human connection, if you will, right? Where you're able to really both get to know your clients personally as well as professionally, while you're trying to also work closely with them in solving their business needs. So it actually has worked out far better than I would have ever imagined. And I've had the privilege of being able to meet more clients than I think I would ever have met in my first 6 months with the company. So that's worked out really, really well.
Therein lies some of the conundrum or some of the things we've discovered over this year of COVID-19 is that within some of these challenges, some opportunities have made things more possible, more successful even, which is just wild and hard to believe. So it's been a wild ride, to say the least, as you've been here these 6 months. We are in the current situation. We can see some light at the end of the tunnel, but we've always had to project out several years in any venture. What do you see currently for Hitachi Vantara and yourself? And what do you see near future and long-term future?
The mantra that we are starting to really embrace at Hitachi Vantara is really think outside in, right? So start with the market, then understand your client and their specific needs, and then how do we partner in solving that? And hence, you know, goes back to the significant amount of time that we spend with our clients and our partners to really understand what their needs are. And the one thing that jumps out is that cloud acceleration is actually, you know, going even faster than we would have expected it, right? And I think that over the next 3 to 4 to 5 years, you're going to see the cloud acceleration become a significant portion of what our clients do. And that's going to lead to our clients wanting to, you know, either transform their business, build new businesses, create better commerce systems, you know, and so on and so forth. And to do that, they need a infrastructure and a set of capabilities that allow them to do that, right? Because they need to be able to operate in a private cloud environment, in a public cloud environment, in a hybrid environment, as well as with this acceleration, a multi-cloud environment, which means they're operating across a couple of different hyper-cloud providers. But a majority of our clients are actually looking for help to make that transition. And in doing so, they recognize today that data is sitting at the very core of it, right? And so, you know, our view is, you know, we come from data, right? We come from core data storage, and we are making that migration to, you know, helping clients manage their data, helping clients manage and execute data from the edge, from the core, and from the cloud. And so they're building data-driven businesses, and we think that we have the opportunity to work very closely with our clients to enable them to build and operate data-driven businesses and deliver data-driven outcomes. We think that that's a sweet spot for us, and we are super excited about it.
Exciting spot to be in when you consider how important data is at the core of the business. And as you've led NerveWire and Cognizant to other successes and growth, we can probably see that here happening at Hitachi Vantara as well. And I appreciate your time. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you. Thanks, JB. Appreciate it.
That's Gajen. I want to thank him so much. And as always, I want to thank you, the viewer, for being with us. This is HVTV.